Hello students, today we will discuss question answer of deep water. So what is the first question? First question could be, what is the significance of the title deep water, or the title of the lesson deep water is appropriate or not? So the title is very appropriate because the whole story revolves around deep water. Deep water represents the troubles or the darkness of life or the struggles of life. In the same way, in this particular lesson, William Douglas, who had hydrophobia or fear of water, so how he had come an aversion of water, how he struggled during his younger stage, and how he had overcome his fear of water. Everything has been described about water, and from very starting to end, water or the problems of water has been described. So the title is very appropriate. Now come to the second question might be related to mother, that why did mother continually want William Douglas about going to Yakima River. So mother was continually warned against going William Douglas into Yakima River because Yakima River was treacherous and it was dangerous to go there because many persons had already drowned in the river and they had lost their lives. But YMCA pool, that was safe because it was only 2 to 3 feet deep at the shallow end and it was 9 feet deep at the other end. So that was a safe pool where one could learn swimming, while the Yakima River was dangerous because it had taken so many lives. So we'll continue. After that, next question could be that is related to aversion. How did William Douglas had an aversion to water? So when question is asked about aversion, you will have to tell about when he was only of 3 or 4 years old. So when he was only 3 or 4 years old, at that time he had started an aversion. What really had happened, you will have to tell that his father took him to the beach in California. He and his father, they were standing in the surf and a wave knocked him down. At that time he was buried underwater and his breath was gone, and after that he was totally frightened, and from that point a terror took a type of hold in his heart. So that was an aversion. After that he had started an aversion or dislikeness of water and he never gone near water. But at last, at the age of 10 or 11 years, he had started to also to learn swimming. So at the age of 10 or 11 years, he had started how to swim. Next question comes about, that is related to sometime question asked about the Big Bruiser boy. Describe a brief character sketch of Big Bruiser boy who had thrown William Douglas into swimming pool. So the Big Bruiser boy probably was of 18 years old. He had thick hair on his chest. He was a beautiful physical specimen, a model with legs and arms showed rippling muscles. So he was a strong and having a strong body. Next question comes that what misadventure happened to him. So what was the misadventure that William Douglas speak about? So misadventure that William Douglas speak about was at the age of 10 or 11 years. When he was only 10 or 11 years old, there happened a misadventure. And what was misadventure? A Big Bruiser boy he had thrown him into the swimming pool. And he was almost drowned. You will not have to explain everything, but you will have to explain only that in short. If it is asked as a long answer, then you will have to explain everything, the series of emotion he had experienced in the swimming pool. But if it is asked only, normally it is asked as a short answer question, so you will have to tell that he was almost drowned, but anyhow he was saved. So from that day onwards, he had such a fear in his heart about water that it remained throughout so many years with him. So that was the misadventure. Next question about the series of emotions we will take from the text, if these questions are in text. Yes. The first question is, what is the misadventure that William Douglas speaks about? We had right now discussed about it. The next is, what were the series of emotions and fears that Douglas experienced when he was thrown into the pool? And what plans did he make to come to the surface? So, what were the series of emotions that Douglas experienced when he was thrown into the pool? So, Douglas experienced a series of emotions. He was totally panicked when the big bruiser boy threw him into the swimming pool. He landed in a sitting position. So he was going in a sitting position into the water, and he was going slowly. At first he thought that he would go fastly, and he would he had also a strategy. What was the strategy or the plan he made to come out of to the surface? He was thinking that he would just touch the bottom and jump or spring like a cork and come to the surface, lie flat there, and by paddling his legs and hands, thrashing water with the help of his hands, he would reach to the edge of the pool and be safe. So that was his planning. But while he was going, he had a series of emotions. His lungs were ready to burst because he had swallowed water instead of air. And while he was going down, he was totally panic. He was seized. And as he touched the bottom, he made a jump, but there was no difference. And he came up slowly. And after that, he had experienced a panic as he was coming slowly above. He was feeling that he a type of mass of water held him, and that was also yellow water, dirty and yellow water, because he couldn't see through. He was crying, he was speaking for help, but the voice was not coming out of his mouth. Even he was crying, but no one was hearing, only water was hearing. Everywhere there was water and water. He tried for ladder, he tried for other water wings or many things, but he couldn't do anything. So now next, what he had done, slowly he came up. His nose and his eyes came out in the sunlight, but after that he tried with his legs, his hands, so that he could come to the surface, but it didn't happen because it seems that his legs and his hands were paralyzed. So he was going down again, and he was totally panicked while he was going down second time. But even his head was throbbing at that time, and his heart was also pounding. These were two things that he was thinking, that he is alive. Otherwise, every part of his body was not working. It seems that he was totally paralyzed, he was panicked. And even then, he was in his wits, and he was thinking that whenever he would touch the bottom, he would come out to the surface from the last strategy he had done. So in the midst of the terror, he touched the bottom because he had remembered it already. So he tried whatever the strength he had, but nothing was done. He came up once again slowly in the same way. His body was totally paralyzed. He couldn't move legs. He even
His throat choked and he couldn't cry. He was trying to cry. He cried for help. He even cried for mother's help, but nothing happened there. So these were the series of emotions he had experienced at that time. Because third time when he was going down, all efforts ceased. Now the next question comes that how did this experience affect him? So this experience affected him badly. He couldn't even sleep properly. He was trembling while he was sleeping. He couldn't eat on that day. And even after that, not only that day, after that, he couldn't even enjoy a single day. The haunting fear of water that was making his life troublesome. Because he couldn't even go to near to water. His friends were enjoying, but he couldn't go. As ever he tried for that, the haunting fear came again and again. And that's why he couldn't enjoy anything. So this experience affected him very badly. He couldn't enjoy the water activities. Next, if we come, a question comes there that we have discussed in the series of emotions, that in the midst of the terror, I have already discussed about that, that what in the midst of the terror came a touch of reason. So what was touch of reason? So touch of reason was the part of strategy that whenever he would hit the bottom, he would make a big jump. That was part of his strategy. So he also thought about that, and as his toes reached to the bottom, he jumped with everything whatever he had. So that was an important question. Next important question comes about what happened when all efforts ceased. So when all efforts ceased, he thought that he couldn't jump, he couldn't try, because his whole body parts were paralyzed. Even he is saying that his left his legs were also lifeless. So when all efforts ceased, it seemed to him that a blackness swept over his brain, and it wiped out any type of fear for him. There was no more panic, and there was only peace. He was not afraid of anything, and he was thinking that it is going to be sleepy, drowsy. And he was also thinking that he was floating in space, and her mother's tender arms are also around him. So at that time he was going to be unconscious. That was the part, because everything becomes dark for him. Before that his mind and his heart was working, but right now it seems that nothing was working for him, or the curtain, the life's curtain was falling for him. The next question we should discuss is next, why was Douglas determined to get over his fear of water? Why he was determined? He was determined to get over his fear of water because it deprived all the water activities for Douglas. He couldn't enjoy canoeing. He couldn't enjoy fishing, boating, swimming, as his other friends were doing. And wherever he went, the water fear, hydrophobia followed him everywhere. He tried in water lakes, waterfalls, and other opportunities. Wherever he went, this fear haunted him. And that's why he determined to get over his fear of water. Next question. How did the instructor build a swimmer out of Douglas? Next, finally, 1 October, Douglas decided that he should hire an instructor. So that instructor, how he built a swimmer out of Douglas? He taught him 5 days a week, an hour each day. And how did he taught? He put a belt around Douglas. He put a belt around Douglas, and this belt was attached to a rope, and that was attached with a pulley. And the other end that was caught by instructor. So what they were doing, sometime the instructor was losing the rope, in that way Douglas was going into the water, and sometime instructor was holding the rope tight so that he could come out. But it took 3 months that the problems became to slack or to less. After 3 months, when he could move, he could go underwater, and after that he taught him how to inhale, how to take breath in, and how to outhale or exhale, how to breathe out. Saans lena kaise hai, saans chhodna kaise hai, they were taught after that. And after that he taught him how to move his legs or the paddling. So he had taught him also the paddling. And also it took few weeks, because at first they were frozen, they were paralyzed, but at last he could command them or them. So piece by piece, part by part, the instructor taught him how to swim, and at last he integrated the every piece and said him that you have to swim now. So at last he could swim the whole length of the, but even then he was not satisfied. At last that is in March, in April, in about 6 months, after 6 months, it took 6 months to teach him swimming. So after 6 months he had perfected him as a swimmer. Next question is, how did Douglas make sure that he conquered the old terror? Very important question. Sometimes question is asked in that way. How did Douglas finally overcome his fear of water? Finally overcome his fear of water. So Douglas makes sure that he had conquered, because he had residual doubts even after the finishing of the instructor. Instructor was finished. Instructor's work was finished. He had taught him every stroke of swimming. But even then, Douglas had some doubts. And to clear his doubts, firstly he went to Wentworth, to Lake Wentworth. That is this Lake Wentworth in New Hampshire. And after that, he swam there 2 miles. But even then, some part of terror returned there, and he went to, that is Warm Lake. He went in the Conard Meadows in Warm Lake. He went there in Warm Lake, and he swam there up and down at the both shore. And after that, he at last with a confidence, he said that I have conquered my fear of water. So you will have to give 2 examples. That is related to Wentworth. First is of Wentworth. He swam there 2 miles, and another is of Warm Lake. He swam there up and down. These 2 examples, finally he had overcome with the help of these 2 practice. Next question comes, how does Douglas make clear to the reader the sense of a panic that gripped him as he almost drowned? Describe the details that have made the description vivid. So how does Douglas make clear to the reader the sense of panic that gripped him as he almost drowned? So Douglas make clear to the reader the sense of a panic gripped him as he was almost drowned by describing the each and every part in a very graphical manner. That when a big bruiser boy had thrown him into the swimming pool, he told that how it happened. He told each and every part, and it seems that that was really vivid. The description was the series of emotions we have already discussed, and that is also the part of this question. We can explain each and everything, that how he had gone first time, how he had gone second time, and how he tried, what was his strategy. So the description was totally vivid, because he had shown in that way that it's real, that you have experienced it. It seems that just you are listening the story, and author is in front of you, and he is telling in that way, that like you were eyewitness. The next question, how did Douglas overcome his fear of water? Very important question. It could be asked as a long answer as well. So how did Douglas overcome his fear of water? Douglas firstly hired an instructor. And how instructor made a swimmer out of Douglas? So you will have to define all those things, that how he had made a swimmer out of Douglas. Second, also include finally, he was not satisfied even with instructor, and he tried firstly in swimming pool up and down for till April to July it happened, and after that he had gone to Lake Wentworth, and after that he had also gone to Warm Lake. So here he swam for 2 miles, and here up and down. So you will have to add everything, every matter he had tried for overcoming fear of water. The next question: why does Douglas as an adult recount a childhood experience of a terror and his conquering of it? What larger meaning does he draw from this his experience? Very important question. Why does Douglas as an adult recount an childhood experience of terror? Because he had experienced such a terror in his life and also conquered it. So he had both the experience, and this is the larger meaning he had experienced. That he also has described that in death there is only peace. There is only fear in the fear of death. Fear is only in the fear of death, or the fear it can produce. So he is giving a larger meaning from it, that when you are in any type of fear, you are always in fear if of that fear. But if you reach near the fear, if you overcome the fear, there will be total peace. And even if you are near death, there is also peace. So the only, if you want to live, you will have to overcome from that fear. अगर आप जिंदा रहना चाहते हैं तो आपको उस फियर से ओवरकम करना ही पड़ेगा, अदरवाइज देर इज ऑल्सो पीस इन डेथ. सो ही डिस्क्राइब विद द विल डिटर्मिनेशन, स्ट्रॉन्ग डिटर्मिनेशन, यू कैन ओवरकम फ्रॉम द फियर ऑफ एनीथिंग, बिकॉज ही हैड ऑल्सो कॉन्कर्ड, ही हैड एक्सपीरियंस बोथ थिंग, एंड ही हैड ऑल्सो कॉन्कर्ड. ही वॉन्ट्स टू टेल his reader that with strong will, determination, you can even overcome from any fear, not only water, you can overcome from any type of fear. So work hard with your strong determination, strong will, you can achieve success in any stage, in any field. So that was the motive of William Douglas to mention you about this. Once again the same question: all we have to fear is fear itself. Have you ever had any such circumstance? If it is any circumstance, you can also discuss about it. So that's all about this lesson. We will continue in the next.